Dudes always like holding their farts around them.
Oh, no.
Have you ever heard this?
No.
You've never heard this?
No.
There's like a whole thing. There's like memes out about it.
Welcome to Uncool with Alexa Bliss. That's me. We have a very interesting episode for you today, featuring one of the coolest WWE superstars on your television today, Tyler Breeze. Before he was Prince Pretty in NXT, he was just Matt. He may have thought he was cool growing up, but after talking through some incredible embarrassing moments, I may have been able to change his mind. So let's go on a journey with Tyler Breeze and learn more about something he likes to call date farts. Welcome to the podcast. I am here with Prince Pretty.
My God. I should just walk out right now.
That's Prince Pretty. A
little respect, please.
King of Cuteville. What was it?
My
definition of delish.
You're just a good host, aren't
Tyler
you?
Tyler Breeze. I am a fantastic
just
host.
Just a great host.
Fantastic. But before you were Tyler Breeze, King of Cuteville, Prince Pretty, and definition of delish.
There you go.
You were Matt.
Yes.
Yes. You know, a lot of people think that, you know, I mean, I don't, but a lot of people think that you are this really cool, suave, debonair WWE superstar, but I know the real you.
Do you?
I do. The nerdy,
struggling, huh?
Stop staring at me like that.
Struggling to find something.
Stop staring at me like that. So, okay. Who were you before Tyler Breeze?
I mean, apparently you know me so well. Just
I do.
Let me know, what else besides nerdy am I?
A mediocre dancer?
Not mediocre. Horrendous.
Horrendous dancer. I was trying to give you some credit.
No, don't.
Trying to give you some credit.
Not there.
An excellent cook.
Excellent cook. I will take that.
Cook really good box food. And
How dare you.
And, yeah. I mean, I know you said earlier when we were just chatting that I asked you when were you most uncool, and you said I was always cool.
I was always cool.
Is that true?
So, well, it depends. I mean, how far back are we going here?
As far back as you want. Dolph was. I was having a conversation with Dolph. He was saying that he his uncoolness started in kindergarten when he didn't know how to tie his shoes in a shoe tying contest.
Wow.
Yeah. So we're going as far back as you want to go.
Well, so the thing is it's not like I mean, even now, I'll joke about it. Obviously, like, oh yeah, I'm cool, but I've never, like, considered myself cool, but I think my friends think I'm cool.
Do they?
Yeah.
Have they always thought you were cool?
I think so. I've kind of been, like, I've always been kind of, like, a clique jumper.
Right.
So, like, I just kind of get along with, like, everybody.
Right.
Like, there's really not, you know, I wasn't really a kid who was bullied, or I wasn't a bully. Like, I was like, the one who was, like, you know, I make you laugh, and then I go over here, and I make this person laugh, and then we just kind of, like, you know, oh, hey, you know him? Yeah, oh, he's great, cool.
So you're trying to say you were never uncool. You were just always cool.
I don't ever consider myself cool or uncool. I've always been just however people perceive me.
Okay.
I mean, I've had moments probably where
of uncoolness.
Uncoolness.
Can you think of one?
Wait, uncool or like embarrassing? Like, how far are we going here?
We're gonna go both uncool, and then we'll go to embarrassing.
Okay. Uncool. Oh. I mean, it was cool, but I was okay with it. Or no, it was uncool, but I was okay with it. So I played hockey for like 10 years, right?
Yes.
Well, when you wear a helmet, you're like, your hair comes out the back of it, right?
Right.
So hockey hair was a big thing. It basically just when you don't cut your hair at all, it just grows.
Right.
But then when you have a helmet on, you look real cool. Well,
do you?
Yeah, oh yeah, you do.
Okay.
So I was great for a while. But then I was a big WWE fan.
Right.
So I thought Jeff Hardy was very cool. So
he was very cool.
He was awesome. I was starting to grow like a beard, and I was like, I'd get these like little sideburns and thought I was real cool. But anyway, that wasn't even the bad part.
Oh.
Those were all right.
If you guys could see my face right now.
Dude,
oh, yikes. Oh, yeah, there's camera.
But then, so he, you know, he always dyed his hair.
Right.
Like all crazy, right? So I got this big idea. I'm like,
did you
oh,
dye
man.
Your hair?
I'm like, oh, man, I'm going to dye my hair, and it's going to look so cool. I'm going to be just like Jeff. I dyed it red with blonde in the front.
Oh.
Which, as you know, because you have pink hair,
yes,
and everything else, it doesn't last a long time,
no,
and it blends all together,
yes,
if you put blonde with it. So me, like, being like, I don't know, 14, 15, I had red hair with this blonde in it. I was like, man, this is cool. Like, this is really cool. Like, a week later, it was not red anymore. It was pink.
Yes.
And so I had, like, pink hair. And so, obviously, playing hockey with this pink hair,
right,
dipping out the back of my helmet, I might as well just put a big bullseye on me.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah, of, like, you know, everybody who wanted to chirp at me or whatever, it was
That's
like...
It's not even that bad.
It was bad.
Like, oh, I had red hair and it faded to pink.
It was pink. It was bright pink. I was not cool. And so that's my friends who knew me pre-pink hair.
Right.
They stuck with me.
Okay.
But
no one wanted to be friends with you post-pink hair. Like, mid-pink
hair. No. Trying to get a girlfriend with pink hair, no go.
I'd imagine.
And then you should have seen when I cut that pink hair. Like, new kid in school.
Okay.
It was cool.
So this podcast is normally about being relatable and having those moments that aren't
necessarily the coolest
and, you know, let your freak flag fly. But apparently none of that doesn't apply to you because you were just always so
Maybe
cool.
I've, like, shut out
just
my embarrassing
all the girls,
stuff.
You know,
no, I did not get all the girls.
I was so cool.
I wasn't. I was super skinny. I was always really skinny.
Okay.
I mean, that's not like, I don't know, whatever. Oh, so, do you want like an embarrassing story?
No, like, so, hold on, rewind. What do you? So, you were super skinny. What? Elaborate.
Keep in mind, I grew up wanting to be a wrestler, right?
Oh, okay. So you wanted to be big and muscular.
Yeah, of course.
But you grew up super skinny.
Of course, nobody wants to be the skinny little kid in high school.
You can't just be like, oh, I'm
going
skinny.
I'm going to gym class, and there's like these grade 12 dudes with like a full beard, and they're just like pushing all this weight, and meanwhile, I'm like 130 pounds. I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna be in WWE.
Yeah.
They're like, sure. Even my Nana is like, yeah, you're kind of small to be a wrestler. I was like, thanks, Nana. Showed her. But anyway, was there a question in there?
An embarrassing story?
Oh, a full story. Okay.
Do you have any embarrassing stories that you would like to share?
I have an embarrassing story, but I'm not good with embarrassing stories because they're embarrassing, obviously.
Right.
And this is literally the only one that I can think of that I'm like, oh, God, I'm about to tell this. I haven't even thought about this story in a long time. I don't even know if it's that good. I'll have to remember it as I go. But anyway, I remember. So I had to be like grade 11. Something like that. So I don't know. I was what, like 15, 16? Something like that, right? I was kind of... So in my hometown, there was like two schools. So I was like at Penn High, was like the Penticton High School is what it was called. And then Princess Margaret was the other one. Princess Margaret was the other school, which was across town, which sounds like a big thing, but it's like 5 minutes. Like, I was a really small town. But that was like, we didn't know anybody over there, and we
right.
kind of like, nobody intermingled. It was like a big, like, you're this school or this school.
Right.
Well, a buddy of mine started dating this girl who was going to Princess Margaret. So all of a sudden, like, the doors were open to, like, there's a whole new group. Like, we don't know these people. So we started hanging out with, like, this whole new group, and I'm like, I don't know, like, any of these people. It was great. I ended up meeting this girl. Her name's Lauren. And I'm like, oh, Lauren, like, she's pretty cool, and I'm kind of into her. But at this point, like, as much as I said I wasn't, like, uncool, very no confidence, like, no clue, really. Like, 16 years old, you don't know anything. Like, you're just kind of like, oh, God, like, am I funny? Am I,
right.
you know, what does she think of me? I don't know, like, freaking out. But so I'm hanging out with Lauren, and I'm like, cool. She's, like, cool, right? So I think it was, like, me and Lauren were hanging out in, like, the living room of my buddy's house. And then, like, Dave, who was my buddy, he was with, like, Kylie, who ended up being his girlfriend. He married and everything. And then Mike was the other one, and he was with somebody. But it was all kind of like, you know, it was like we were just hanging out.
Hanging out, yeah.
Yeah. And I remember it was, like, late, but it was something where, like, so have you ever heard, like, the, I guess it's a real story, or I guess it's a real, I don't even know what you'd classify it as. There's like a lot of memes about it and stuff like that. But so when you start like when you start hanging out with a girl for the first time, or when you start like going on dates or whatever, there's like a thing about like dudes always like holding their farts around them.
Oh no.
Have you ever heard this?
No.
You've never heard this?
No.
There's like a whole thing. There's like memes out about it where like, you know, like the second that you say bye and the dudes just like go in their car and fart like crazy because they've been holding it in the whole time. So, It's a thing, guys. Google it.
Okay.
But so anyway.
I don't really Google date farts, but
You'll find so much
thing.
Stuff on date farts. It's a thing.
Okay.
So anyway, we've been hanging out for like hours at this point.
And you're just holding them all in.
At least a couple.
You got, at least one or two. They're in the chamber. They're in the holster.
The second I'm out this door, it's happening.
I like how the veins are popping out in your head. You're laughing so hard. Yeah.
Well, I haven't thought. I'm telling you, I haven't thought about this story in so long.
Is it that embarrassing that you just stored it away?
I've blocked it out of my memory. This is like 20 years ago. This is like 20 years ago. Oh my God, I'm old. Anyway, so me and Lauren are hanging out, having a great time, right?
Yep.
Like, this is fun. I'm making her laugh. I'm getting a little confident, whatever. Of course, the house is perfectly silent. I'm in the living room with Lauren, and I'm trying to, like, bridge the gap here of, like, I like you, you know? Like, yeah. She knows. She clearly knows. We've been hanging out and whatever. And I said something. I can't remember what it was. Knowing me, I was probably joking around.
Right.
But I specifically remember I laughed and farted at the same time. But it wasn't like a, like, comical, like, gigantic one. It was one of those ones that kind of, like, it blended in with my laugh. So I didn't fully know if she heard or not.
Like a laugh to fart ratio here that we're talking about?
It was like a rumble.
Like a 50-50?
It was more of like, I was sitting on like a couch or something, right? So it was more of like a rumble and a laugh. But it was like, like, it was like, it could have gone either way.
Right.
But of course, like me being like 15, 16, immediately, like, I just went like, like deer in the headlights. Oh God, did she hear? I don't know. And Lauren, I'm so sorry, but like, she just a champion. Didn't even bat an eye.
Maybe she didn't hear it.
I don't know. That's to this day.
Maybe she didn't hear
it. I don't know if she heard it or not. I never asked. Obviously, I wasn't like.
Well, it's a hashtag ask Lauren.
Did you hear that? Like, no. I tried to just laugh my way through it and hope that she didn't hear. But of course, just terrified. Of course, she heard. Like, she had to have heard. I heard, so she had to have heard. But she's laughing and like didn't mention it whatsoever. And I just went, oh God, like, just try to go past this. And I couldn't get past it. I think we like either went in the other room or like stopped hanging out like almost immediately after that.
Really?
Yeah. I was like, she had to have heard.
You just bailed at that moment.
I had to, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Pull the plug and run.
Wow.
Yeah. Try my luck with the next one.
Yeah. So we don't laugh too hard with the next one.
Well, I mean, yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
I can honestly say I've never had that happen to me.
Like a dude fart?
No, that for sure.
Yeah.
No, but like to me specifically.
Oh, yeah. No,
I can honestly say I've never had that happen. I don't know what I would do if I had that happen, especially because girls, it's different for girls. Like, we're supposed to be very, you know, prim, proper ladies.
Girl. No, the other way around, it would never happen. Never happen.
That's the thing. I don't even think that's ever happened to me.
But so let's just, for the sake of argument here.
Okay.
Let's say you're in the scenario.
Right.
You're playing the role of Lauren.
Right. I would call you out immediately.
That's what I figured.
Yeah.
That's what I figured.
But I'm also not super polite in that sense.
Well.
Like, because I find things extremely funny.
Yes.
And I'd be like, oh my God, you just did that, and start laughing with you about it to make you feel more comfortable.
But would you do that?
I'm still going to call you out on it.
But would you do that even like back at like 14, 15 year old you?
100%.
Really?
100%. I've always been a
Nah, there's no way.
Always. I've always been a
There's no way.
Have you had any other embarrassing stuff like that happen like in your career, like even like in NXT or like any weird stories?
Not from me. So like, That was like 16-year-old me.
Yeah.
Once I kind of like grew up to like me, there's so many tactics that'll never happen to me again.
So do you just not fart around girls now in general? Like, are you that traumatized from it?
No. But the thing is, it's not like a traumatizing thing. Now it would never happen because I just know what to do.
Just really pucker up.
No, you just I disappear for a minute or two and then all of a sudden I'm back. I go.
Take the courtesy walk and then come back.
Hey, I'll be right back. Now, obviously, knowing this, it'd be like, yeah, he's going to fart.
Have you done anything embarrassing in NXT? Like, I know for me, like in NXT, like I remember William Regal gave me a challenge one time when he was producing an NXT live event to do a comeback of all drop kicks. Hmm. Now, I don't know if you know this, but when girls, I don't know if it's the same for guys, when girls do drop kicks, when you're first learning them, we always pee. Like, we pee ourselves.
Really?
Yes.
I did not know that.
We all land and ask any girl who's ever thrown a drop kick, guarantee you she's peed at one point.
I've never peed throwing a dropkick. So that's a girl thing.
It must be a girl thing. Like, Sarah even warned us. She goes, now you might pee. So, like, wow. It's normal.
Okay.
I did a whole comeback of dropkicks, and about, it was about 6 dropkicks, and on third dropkick, I felt myself starting to pee, and I was like, no, I have 2 more.
Whoa.
And then, literally, and I was in, like, my royal blue gear.
Oh, can't even hide it. Can't even hide it.
You could see that I had piddled a little bit. Not a lot, but just, like, enough to where you know it's there.
Yeah.
And I was so embarrassed because I was dropkicking Charlotte, too. So she was, like, taller, so I had to really get up there.
Yep.
And, the higher you go, the harder you fall. And the harder you fall, the more I peed. So that happened.
So, wait, so you pee yourself on dropkicks, but you hit your little splash thing. No pee.
That's like thighs. I hit thighs on that.
Okay. All right.
Still to this day, I have to like make sure that I don't have to pee before throwing a drop kick.
Wow.
It's a thing.
Yeah, that's not a thing for dudes.
Girls have like really sensitive bladders, I guess.
I guess. That's
because when we land right here, like we have to pee.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't know. No. So I have not had any stories like that where I'm wrestling, like where I pee or like fart or like, you know, myself or something. I know a lot of guys who have.
Yeah.
I just never had. I've had a couple times where I almost threw up in the ring, and that was like a full out like
from being sick or
combo. So
previous night before.
No, never that.
Okay.
One, I was so blown up. I was super tired.
Okay.
My match was Sami Zayn.
Yeah.
You'll see it because there's a close up of my face. But
you just look like you're gonna vomit.
There was something where it was some big false finish thing. I think maybe a super kick one. And he kicks out, and I'm laying down, and I'm just staring straight ahead. And you can see on my face, and I'm thinking in my head at that moment, I just went, I'm about to puke on national TV. It's going to happen. Like, it's about to happen. I can't do anything about it. It's going to happen. And somehow it didn't. And that was like, that was the one time because I was so blown up that it happened. And the other time was in Belfast or Dublin, and I was sick. I'm the most sick I've ever been. And I couldn't leave the locker room the entire time. Like, I couldn't walk 5 feet from the locker room. I'd have to run back. And I just threw up everywhere, basically. I threw up all intermission. I was right after intermission with Dolph. And I just told him, I was like, hey, man, like, if I crawl under the ring, like, just leave me for a second. He's like, okay. And as we're, like, working and stuff like that, I was okay. I guess I puked my guts out right before we went out. And I was okay. But, like, of course, I think everybody got sick that trip.
Yeah.
And Dolph the next night, he almost I saw him, like, his head was in the apron at one point, but
no.
He didn't puke, but it was like very, very close.
Yeah.
But luckily nothing.
Ooh, that's so scary.
Yeah.
I don't think I've never thrown up in the ring, but I have had a story where I did wrestle a girl. I will not name who she is. She's not with the company anymore, but she did fart in the ring when I hit her with the backhand swing knees. That
sure.
Was the finish. And we were in Fort Pierce, and I hit the forward knees, backward knees, hit them, cover. The referee goes, 1, 2, 3, what the heck is that?
Yep.
And she just has this traumatized look on her face, and she looks up and she goes, Sticks, I farted. Because I knocked it out of her with the knees.
So I've had, I can't remember who it was.
She was so traumatized. She was so.
I can't remember who it was, but somebody farted. So, like, everybody, it was like an 8-man tag.
Yeah.
And we all made our entrances, and somebody farted in the corner. And it destroyed the whole ring to the point where we all jumped out of the ring, and we're like, no, dude, like, no, no. And he's in there, and he's like, what? And we're like, so bad. Like, we're not starting. We're not starting. And it took, like, probably 2 or 3 minutes before we even got back in. We're like, no.
What?
No. Like, is it gone? No, it's not. We're leaving.
No.
But yeah, so it happens. But luckily, I've never had it happen.
Yeah. Dang.
Yeah.
So you've pretty much been cool your whole life.
Not cool my whole life. Not cool. I've just been very lucky. Except for with Lauren. Damn.
We've established that you're bad at dancing. Is there anything else
so bad.
You're bad at?
So believe it or not, this is like a really weird one. And I tried to explain it to people before, and they don't understand it. But in like real life, I'm like a pretty shy person.
Right.
Like, so I'm not like what you see as I'm holding this microphone,
right,
and as I'm like Tyler
Breeze.
No, like dancing, like if I have to dance or something like that, never. Like, cause it's not.
I've noticed.
I'm not Tyler Breeze when I'm dancing. I'm me.
Right.
So, like, I am not good. I've
well, you did the Bella booty shake pretty well when you were greasy Bella.
When I'm dressed like a girl, I could do whatever.
Right.
But when I'm just me,
so that's the key.
The only thing that goes through my head is the Hitch movie.
Yep.
And he's like,
Q-tip.
Just keep your hands here.
Q-tip.
And all you do is just this. No, not those ones.
Oh.
Not those ones.
Just he's like, you live
safe,
right here.
You have to, yeah, the safe dance.
Is where you live. They don't need no
right here,
they don't need
you
no pizza.
Step back and forth.
They got food there.
That's all you got. That's the only thing that goes through my head is that I'll never venture out from it just because I just think I look so stupid.
Well, that's everyone. Everyone thinks that.
Well, that's just my thing. I can't, whatever it is in my head, I'll never think, like, I'll never go, man, I look cool dancing right there.
Right.
Never, not ever.
Well, if you have enough, like, you know, liquid courage, maybe.
No. So at my sister's, so actually, have you ever seen the movie Footloose?
No.
My God.
I know.
You are so young.
I know. Everyone's giving me looks right
so,
now.
So Footloose, growing up, my sister, she's 4 years older than me. She had, like, go-to movies that anytime her and her friends hung out, they watched.
Right.
It was Grease. It was Footloose. It was Dirty Dancing.
Oh, and the other two.
Yeah. So Footloose had Kevin Bacon in it, and it was, I thought it was so cool because at the end, he, like, there's this big fight scene. Oh, yeah, you're so tough, 5-1. He does this big jumping kick. I thought it was so cool. But the whole movie is about dancing. Like, the
right.
town isn't allowed to dance and everything else, not to get into Footloose. But at my sister's wedding, there was some people there that made this delicious sangria. And I had a bunch of it.
Right.
My sister, to this day, she goes, she said I turned into Footloose and was dancing, but I don't think I was. And, I mean,
but the sangria was telling you.
I remember drinking a lot of sangria, and I remember, like, making everybody laugh and, like, just being.
It was probably from your dancing.
I remember being on. But I don't remember me
I
dancing.
I was on. I was cool that
oh,
night.
Dude, I was killing. I was throwing out, like, jokes here and there, and everybody's laughing.
Yeah.
And like, he's so cool, whatever.
I bet you were dancing, and they're like, no one stop him. He's killing it. In his head, he's killing it.
I honestly don't think I was dancing, but apparently I was. But, yeah, no, I'm not. Dancing dancing is, like, the one thing I don't know. I just can't ever
think. Is there anything else that you're bad at?
Probably. Oh, so I was saying,
probably
something. I can't think of it.
everything else I'm good at.
So no, it's not that at all. So remember I was saying I was like, in real life, I'm pretty shy.
Right.
So anything that has like the spotlight on me, I do not like. So like if I was standing up and like giving like a speech or mm-hmm. like, I went and read like a script a couple months ago
mm-hmm.
and it's like a paragraph, right? Like it's
right.
nothing even big. And my heart was pounding out of my chest because I'm like,
the pressure's on.
Well, and there's like four people staring at me.
Right.
So it's not just like I'm not cool having all the eyes on me when it's not wrestling.
Right.
You know what I mean? So like it's very, very intimidating for me.
It's different to wrestling than versus talking in front of people, especially because, you know, I think it's easier to get to blank out and to forget. Do you know what I'm saying? Like it's
oh,
easier
totally.
To blank out on a promo, I think, than it is in a match.
Well, and not even like blanking out, but like just you are so you're so aware of all the eyes on you.
Yes.
So like I did one of Dolph's comedy shows, and the first like minute was me doing like stand up comedy before somebody else came in and we did
right.
like a little skit. That minute felt like 10 hours of my life, and all the eyes are just staring at me, and I went like, and I'm trying to like calm down.
My hands are getting sweaty thinking
yeah,
about
it. Yeah, and I'm like, this is not like, I don't know how guys do like 20 minute sets up here
right.
where like I can hear somebody like clearing their throat or like a, you know, a fork
right.
on the table. Like they're all staring at me and they're like, do something to make me laugh. And
right.
I'm going like,
that's a lot of pressure.
Yeah, horrible. So like any situation like that where all the eyes are on me or it's a spotlight on me or whatever. Very uncomfortable for me, which is funny because of what we do, but
right.
very, very uncomfortable.
Makes sense, though.
Yeah. So, and literally anything that goes along with that. Dancing, I mean, obviously is the main one. And that's solo dancing, by the way. If I was dancing with a girl or something, easy. I can do that. No, I'm not fast dancing. I can't fast dance.
So you can do your hitch dance, but as long as there's a girl right in front of you.
No, like
saying.
I can do like the like high school slow dance.
That's what I'm saying. Like
yeah.
The back and forth.
No, like when you slow dance, you're like holding each other.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. There's no hitch dance. Hitch dance would be like the fast dance, and I haven't braved that yet.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if I could do that.
Wow. You were a big wrestling fan growing up. Did you dress up like wrestlers for Halloween?
I actually never did that.
Okay.
I never did the like, you know, dress up like whoever. I just never
right.
did. I never did.
What did you dress up as?
I think I got embarrassed dressing up, obviously. Ironically. Obviously. Ironically.
Yep.
So, like, when I was a kid, my nana used to make, like, Halloween costumes and stuff for us. So I had, like, Captain Planet, and it had this, like, muscle suit. It was awesome. And, like, green spiked hair and stuff. Do you even know who Captain Planet is?
Nope.
My God. But, so anyway, so Captain Planet.
Before my time.
I think I was, like, Freddy Krueger. That might have been my last one. Freddy Krueger was probably
Freddy
when
Krueger's
I was, like,
cool.
I don't know, like, 10 or 11.
Did you have any embarrassing ones?
Embarrassing costumes?
Halloween costumes.
Oh, never, never.
Really?
No. Well, maybe when I was like, no, because even when I was a kid, like, I don't really remember it. Like, my mom would be like, hey, you're dressing up like a teddy bear. Or, like, you're dressing, you know what I mean? Like, and looking back, they'd probably be, like, cute. Like, I don't think they ever dressed me up like something stupid.
Right.
But I just stopped dressing up, like, early. So, like, I think I was,
oh,
like,
you're that cool.
Yeah, well, I was just like, yeah, I'm not dressing up. I'm not trick-or-treating anymore. I'm, you know, 10. You know what I mean? So.
I trick-or-treated until I was 13.
I know. Some people do.
So growing up, were you afraid of anything? I mean, you were too cool to trick-or-treat, but did you have any fears?
I was afraid of everything. I was legit afraid of everything. So, like, here's one story that kind of, it's so weird, but it's whatever. So, all right, I just remember this. So I was very scared of, like, bugs.
Okay.
I did not like bugs at all. Like, if there was, like, a bug, I would freak out and, like,
yeah,
run away, full run away.
Disgusting.
But so, like, I was scared of, like, a lot of stuff. I was scared of water. Like, even now, like, I'm not, like, a big swimmer. Which, I'm okay to, like, swim in, like, a pool or something.
Right.
But, like, I'm not, like, a strong swimmer.
I can't do the ocean or anything.
No, well, if I go in the ocean, sharks. Super scared of sharks. I've watched too many videos of shark attacks
right.
that I freak myself out. So, sharks, I'm still scared of. I wasn't scared of sharks when I was a kid because I wasn't near an ocean. I was near lakes.
Right.
And even then, I was like, oh, there's no sharks in here. But... I mean, there was stuff. I don't know. But there was no, like...
There were bugs.
It's a lot different than, like... So where I was from, there was no, like, alligators.
Right.
But there was no whatever. But there was, like, snakes and stuff. I grew up, like, with snakes, and it was no big deal to me. But water, I was scared of. I did not like water. I did not like bugs at all. I was a very picky eater. So I didn't like... it's very weird. So, like, my mom would make me muffins every morning. Like, my nana would make all these muffins, and then I'd cut them in half and put peanut butter on them and warm them up, and that was, like, my breakfast. But I'm very, like, I like having one hand free, and I don't like having stuff all over me. So, like, obviously I'm eating a crumbly muffin with, like, peanut butter all over it, right? I would have, like, a little washcloth there because, like, I would eat, like, a little bit and then, like, have to, like, wipe my hands off because I don't like...
You don't want peanut butter fingers.
No, or,
like,
muffin
that's a normal
fingers
thing.
Or whatever. You
yeah.
know what I mean? I just...
want
Nobody wants muffin fingers.
Nobody wants muffin fingers. Nobody wants peanut butter fingers.
No, you know what I mean? So, like, it's... There was a lot of stuff that I was I didn't like or was scared of. But so there was one story where when you make the transition as a young boy
from,
you know, like the little kid underwear to like the big boy boxers.
Uh-huh.
Right? Well, in the front of so stupid. In the front of the boxers, or
uh-huh.
at least the ones I had. There
There's
was
like a,
it's like open.
Yeah, it's like
with
a slit.
Like a little button.
Right.
Well, I didn't like that because I just thought it was kind of uncomfortable.
Huh.
So I got the big idea when I was like, I don't know, 10 or 12 or something, to sew them all shut.
Oh no.
So I did. And as I'm like sewing them, my dad's like, "What are you doing?" And I was like, "Dad, this doesn't make any sense. Like, these aren't comfortable to me." So we had, like, a big fight over it. Like, he was like, he's like, no, like, don't be weird. Like, just let it go. Like, this is whatever, man. Like, you're growing up. And I'm just like, well, like, I'm not cool with this.
Right. Like, what if you're walking and then something happens? You know what I'm saying?
There you go. I'm used to, you know.
You're used to the closure.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm,
the
yeah.
extra protection
this
there.
I'm in a weird place here.
Right. Not understanding.
So I basically get in trouble for sewing all the front of my boxers shut.
Right.
What a, oh man, so when I started this off by saying I've never been uncool, I'm like extremely uncool all the time. So do my boxer shit.
At least it wasn't like Velcro. You know what I mean? That would have been.
Oh my God, I don't even think they make that. But anyway, so I sew them shut. And my dad basically gets mad at me and is like, this is like, no, you're not doing this. So he stopped me from sewing the rest of them shut. Big flip out from me. This is the worst. You guys suck. I hate this. Whatever. I run into my room. They're the worst, you know, the whole exactly how you'd picture
right.
it. I'm crying, like, you know, I just want to sew them shut. I jump on my bed, and as I jump on my bed, my head hits the pillow, and my hand goes on my pillow. Well, on my pillow is a gigantic June bug. It's like a big beetle. My hand grabs the beetle. So, as my hand grabs the beetle, I go, like, what is that? I lift my hand up and look at the beetle. I'm terrified of all, right. All things bug related. Jump up, run out of my room screaming. My dad's like, what is going on? And I'm already crying from right. like before.
From the boxers.
And,
I'm
like, and he's like, what just happened? You were in there for like a second. And he goes in there and sees this like bug on my pillow and just starts laughing. And just like, what are you doing? Like,
first you're sewing your boxers shut.
Yeah, get a hold of yourself, man.
Of a bug.
Yeah, and so,
get
and
yourself together, man.
Meanwhile, I'm just a mess. I'm just like crying and like there's bugs.
You're like,
and
I don't understand why boxers and holes.
What is going on?
Boxers and bugs, man.
Boxers and bugs. The
yeah, you were definitely
story.
The coolest person I know, from what it sounds like.
Well, I don't think of these stories all the time. So there's another one. It's not really like a story, but it's like a, I guess it's a thing. So I like being very organized.
Yes.
So I like having my things in certain spots.
Okay.
So, oh my God, this is like, no, because this is even now, it's so uncool. I don't think about myself like this. So I'll tell that one in a second. I'll tell it right now. So I have a lot of clothes. I have a lot of clothes.
Right.
I have shirts. I have like a million t-shirts. Okay. And every time I go like, oh, I'm going to go through them and like, I'm only going to have like 10. It never happens. I go, oh, I need this because of this. And this is.
And then that one time that you throw it away, you're like, oh, I could have
worn that
one shirt.
Yeah. Yeah. So anyway, I have like 3 stacks of t-shirts and I'm very specific on when I do laundry. The new shirts, the clean shirts have to go at the back of the line because I feel like the rest of the shirts will get like.
Upset that
they don't get worn as many times.
So you have like an assembly line of shirts. Like you have to go back to the line. I just wore you this week.
When I was a kid, I used to have a chart. When I wore the shirt, it would get a tick.
Well, if I've ever heard anything that's super cool, it's a shirt chart.
First off, I'm giving you the parts of my life here that I've blocked out.
This is a safe space. The only people that will know this is me, you, and whoever's listening to the podcast.
As a 32-year-old man, I have gotten rid of my shirt chart.
But you still have the assembly line.
I do that for all of my stuff, my hats, my shirts, everything, shorts. It's all like a whole thing, yeah. But when I was a kid,
okay,
very organized, very practical. I have to have things in certain order, right?
Mm-hmm.
Whenever anybody came over, like my mom would have friends that came over and they had kids, I would barricade my room so that nobody could go in my room and mess up my toys because my toys were in a certain spot.
Oh, no.
And I'd get very upset. And my mom would be like, what are you doing? And meanwhile, I'm like behind the door with like something holding the
right.
the knob. Like
protecting my toys.
He's not coming in.
Spot.
He's not playing with my stuff.
Right.
And that's like, that's kind of how I've always been of like, I like things in a certain place and don't move them on me.
What would you do if your dogs randomly got into your drawer and messed up all your shirts?
Well, so
and
I'm
you're like, no, I don't know when I wore
no,
that.
I'm a little more relaxed now. I just, it like, if all of a sudden, so, like, this happens all the time, the stack of shirts falls.
Oh, no.
What do we do?
Not fall.
I don't have a panic attack. I put them back in whatever order. Like, it'll be okay.
And then someone's like, hey, you just wore that Mouse Rat shirt last week.
First off, Mouse Rat rules.
It does.
And it's my favorite shirt. I'll wear that every day. But, no, it's a lot more relaxed. It's not like I go traveling and have to pack, like, 3 sets of everything. You know what I mean?
I do that. I pack 3 sets of everything. I used to pack 3 of everything. A backup and then a backup for my backup. Like 3 toothbrushes. I have OCD. 3 toothbrushes, 3 sanitizers, 3 packs of gum, 3 deodorants.
Backup for the backup
just
for the backup.
Just in case. Just in
Who
case.
Who packs a backup for the backup for the backup?
I did. And then I went down to 2. And now I just travel with 1. And then if I need a backup, I just buy it.
See? It's growth, people.
Yes.
The shirt chart's gone.
Yep.
2 packs of unnecessary traveling.
Yeah.
We're growing as humans.
Circling back to growth as a human being, what would you tell your former self, specifically your crying over boxers and bugs self, what would you tell that version of Matt today?
I would say, look, man, I understand. I still don't like bugs. And you can buy different types of boxers. You know what I mean? They don't all have the little thing in the front.
Do you still not wear the ones with the thing in the front?
No, God, no.
Okay.
I'm comfortable. You know what I mean?
Yes.
I don't need the little thing in the front.
Okay.
When I pee like a 5-year-old. I go all the way down to my ankles. Causes a real scene in public restrooms.
Tyler Breeze, ladies and gentlemen.
You imagine walking in and there's a grown man with his pants around his ankles just standing there peeing.
With his Louis Vuitton shoes.
Yeah, great. But yeah, no, I would tell you, like, just keep doing what you're doing, man.
That's what everyone keeps saying.
Well,
that's good,
in the end, it works
it's
out.
Good,
Look
yeah.
how I turned out. I've turned out okay. I'm okay with myself.
Yes, you did.
I went through a lot of weird stuff. I'm
yeah.
still kind of a weirdo.
And you still wear shirts with giraffes on them.
First off.
It's a cool shirt.
That's so. See, when people make fun of you, little me, when people make fun of you,
little me,
it means they think you're cool. They're into your stuff.
Yeah. Thank you for being on the podcast. I appreciate it. I hope you had fun, and I hope that, you know, it wasn't too brutal for you.
No, it reminded me of a lot of things. I haven't thought of these memories and you know, these weird stories in a long time.
Good.
Long time.
Good.
Jogging my memory here. So next time I say that I'm really cool,
I
never will, but just remind me that, yeah, I'm not.
Thanks to Tyler Breeze for joining me on Uncool with Alexa Bliss. If you want more, you can hear a brand new episode right now. Search Uncool with Alexa Bliss on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts, and hit follow or subscribe. New episodes will be released every Tuesday. And let's talk about your uncool moments on social media by using the hashtag UncoolWithAlexa. Thanks again for watching, and remember, it's cool to be uncool.
I'd be like, yeah, boxers and bugs.
You'd be the only one cheering at my funeral. If you want to be that person, go crazy.